Get ready to match the stars. Richard Long, Brett Somers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Joanne Flew, Richard Dawson, and Kay Stevens as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now the star of Match Game 74, Gene Rayburn.
Two of you have your hands up. Do you wish to leave the room so early in the proceedings?
Well, no, I want to know where your captain's hat is.
My captain, Charles has my captain.
I did notice the shoes, and as we're strangers in town, I wonder if you would direct us to the carnival.
No,
did
I bought
you buy
them.
All of Coco the Clown's?
No, I bought these from Emmett Kelly there. No, actually,
I like
these
them.
Are an old pair of golf shoes. Aww. They are. Look at this. I took the spikes
are.
Out.
Oh! They're lovely. They're beautiful. I think that's quite ingenious. You don't let anything go to waste.
That's right.
Well, you
they're
know,
beautiful.
It's they're so
they're
Fred Astaire-ish, aren't they?
Oh, they are
they're very
so
yes, they're lovely.
Yes, I figured.
They're gorgeous.
That. All right, now that you've laughed at my shoes.
Take it off!
Whoever can wear that can go to the ball.
Fill it with champagne.
What do you say we greet our two players here,
yeah,
Kathy Graff and Dick Harper? Hello there. Kathy's our current champ. She's won $7,150. And she's being challenged by Dick Harper, who did not do well in his first round question and matched four celebrities in his second round question. Now you have to match four to stay in the game with your second round question. Five, however, will win another game for you. And we'll find out how that comes out right after this message of interest to all. In a rash moment, I kicked my shoe down, and a lady in the first row caught it, and in order to give it back to me, I had to give her a kiss.
Well, a kiss?
I think I'll kick it again there. She's a good kisser, that one down there in the first row. All right, you ready? Here we go. Push this button and reveal a second round question for you, Kathy. Listen carefully. Everybody plays. The Godfather said, most people have their first pair of shoes bronzed.
Well, that's the grandfather, your
me?
Name. Could you speak up?
I
thought it was the aunt.
See, we can't understand.
I had my first blank bronzed. The Godfather said most people have their first pair of shoes bronzed. Me, I had my first blank bronzed.
Well, that's like
that sounds just like Marlon, huh?
Even Marlon doesn't sound
okay.
like Marlon anymore.
Good. Oh, you're all doing so well.
Well, thank you.
Thank you very much.
That's okay.
Is that all right, an explanation?
Yes.
Okay, thank you.
Right. All right. Everybody's ready now?
You good kisser?
Oh, very good kisser, yes.
I'm gonna try.
Okay, put one in the slot there, Kay, and we call on Kathy Graff. The Godfather said most people have their first pair of shoes bronzed. Me, I had my first blank bronzed.
Dead person?
Dead person. Okay, Richard, she said dead person. You've done a lot of dramatic shows. You know about these things, don't you?
Not that dramatic. And what did you do with the spikes?
I said gun.
Gun. That's another good answer. All right, Brett.
I didn't say gun, but I think it's a match.
What?
It's a definite match.
Yes.
It's a killing.
Killing? Yeah, that's a match. Dead person. Charles?
I said gun, too, but I said broad first, but that was being silly. But
oh,
gun.
Gun is the answer. All right, now you must match the three remaining celebrities to achieve a tie. Dead person or body or whatever is what she's looking for. What are you offering?
I said body, dead.
You're offering a body, okay?
If you take her, I also give green stamps.
All right, 4-2. Now, two more bodies and you'll have a tie. Richard?
Hit or body?
Hit or body, all right. Got to match Kay to stay in the game. Kay, it's all on your shoulders.
What is it, Kay?
Kay, what is it?
What
tell
is
us.
It, Kay?
What?
Come on, Kay.
How it?
Body. Tie game. Now, we wipe the slate clean. Wipe the slate clean, shazam. Well, they'll go away after a while. They'll fade away. There you go. Push this button here, nothing happens. There it goes. Everything's weird. And we got a one tie-breaking question for each of you. The one who scored the most will be the winner. Dick, make a choice.
Try A again.
A. All right, here we go. Hey, you hear what happened?
What?
Batman and Robin had a blank. Hear about that? Batman and Robin had a blank.
I don't read Rona Barrett, so I didn't hear about it.
Boy, that was very speedy thinking on your part.
Turn quick.
Okay. Charles is ready. Charles, you ready?
Yes, sir.
Terrific. Everybody ready? Richard, you ready? Richard won. Kay is now ready, so we'll call on Dick Harper. Hey, you hear what happened? Batman and Robin had a blank.
They had a fight.
They had a fight. Okay. Yeah, the audience is kind of with you on that. Richard, are you with him on that?
Absolutely. Fight.
They had a fight. There's one for you, Dick. Brett, tell us about Batman and Robin.
I myself have always been a romanticist.
You have?
Yes.
What do you say?
And I don't believe in violence. They had an affair.
Batman and Robin.
Didn't they, darling?
No, naughty.
Charles, what happened?
9 months later, they had a baby.
Yes, my dear.
All sick.
Yes.
Sad commentary on the panel.
Bunch of weirdos upstairs.
Yes, I
there.
Would believe so.
What have you got?
Obviously, I said fight.
Fight. Two for you, Dick. Richard the second.
Well, they just call it as it really
go ahead,
happened.
Show your answer,
they
Richard.
They had an affair, and they did have a baby.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And then because of talk, they had a wedding.
Oh.
It was nothing gaudy.
A simple wedding.
Just simple shimmy. Well, I don't want to go.
Yeah, no, let's not go into the details. Kay Stevens, may
they're
we see your answer?
Happy.
Fight is the answer. Fight is what you get. Okay. Three for you. All right, you've got your work cut out for you, and we'll see how you do with it right after we see about this. Okay, we're in the middle of a tiebreaker here. Dick has had his question. He's matched three celebrities. Are you ready for yours?
Oh, yeah.
All right. Everybody plays. Tiebreaker, folks. Here we go.
Okay.
The Tin Man goes to a mechanic twice a year for a blank. The Tin Man goes to a mechanic twice a year for a blank.
Right along.
Good, my dear.
I thought that was excellent.
Splendid. All right. Everybody finished down here?
Of course.
Okay, Charles, ready. Now, Kathy Graff, here we go with you. The Tin Man goes to a mechanic twice a year for a...
Tune-up?
Tune-up. The audience seems undecided as to whether that's a good answer or a bad answer. We'll find out right now if it matches any of our celebrities. Richard, does it match you?
No. Afraid I said lube job.
A lube job. Yeah. I guess they like that better. Brett?
All I can say is I've gotten a little tinny in my old age, and I always go for an oil job.
Oh, you do? All right. Charles?
Two oil jobs.
Now you've got to match everyone remaining, Kathy, to stay in the game. Let's find out if it happens. What are you offering here, the Tin Man?
Well, the Tin Man rusts, so he has to have an oiling.
Oiling job, so there's no tune-up there, and Dick Harper wins the game. Congratulations. Come on down, Dick. There's $100 for you, and we'll see how much more you're going to win in a moment or so, but right now we've got to say goodbye to Kathy Graff. She's not leaving here empty-handed. There's a big smile on her face because she has won $7,150. Congratulations and goodbye, Kathy. Thank you. Okay. You're glad to be here, right?
Can't believe it. Very glad to be here.
Well, you better believe it. You are here, Dick Harper, and you're going to have a go at some real big money now. You ready to start?
Yes.
Okay, now you know how this is. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Fruit blank. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. Then if you match the next one, it's $250. If you match a bottom one, it's $100. Three celebrities are allowed to help. Whom do you choose for a little assist?
Brett.
Brett, what do you say?
Aw, you're trying to make up to me and you won. How about fruitcake?
Fruitcake. All right, there's one.
Charles Nelson Riley.
Charles Nelson Reilly.
What all good policemen should wear under their uniform, Fruit of the Loom.
Fruit of the Loom. I'm not going to ask you.
But don't throw out the fruitcake because there could be a file in it.
Joanne.
I think fruit cup.
Fruit cup.
Oh, that's... Well, I think it was very good after all those.
You got fruit cup, you got fruit of the loom, and you've got fruit cake. Now, you may choose one of those, Dick, or think up one of your own. What would you like to do?
I'd like to try fruit cake.
Fruit cake. You think he's right? Okay. So, we're looking for fruit cake. That's Brett's answer. Let's find out if it's up there. And if so, where? First, may we see the $100 response? Fruit salad is a good answer, isn't it? Okay. No fruitcake yet, but I guess that comes later, doesn't it? If you have the salad first, you get the fruitcake later. Now, here is the $250 response. Fruit of the Loom.
All the police get if it's not cake.
I know you don't wear socks. And when you started to make that... All right, we're looking for a fruitcake. Here is the $500 response. Fruitcake! That was Brett's answer. Very good. Okay. So you're up to $600, Dick. Now you're going to try for $5,000. But before you collect the $5,000, you got to match one celebrity. And it has to be an exact match. Now choose one, please.
I have to go back to Brett.
I'm going to go back to Brett. Okay.
Oh, golly.
Here we go. All right, you face me, attaboy. And Brett, Brett, are you there? All right, Brett, here it is.
Don't
the
first thing.
It's blank wax, W-A-X. Blank wax, W-A-X.
So hard when you're working with a man. If it were a lady, you'd know exactly what to say.
No, go with what you
think. Okay, Dick, she finally came up with an answer, and now it's up to you to come up with an answer which you think will match Brett's. Blank wax. What do you put in that blank?
Car.
Car wax. You don't like that? Well, some do and some don't. I don't know. I thought of one. I'll tell you what it was later. Brett, may we see yours for...
I tried so... I said floor wax.
Floor wax. You know, floor wax is good. Car wax is good. You know, I drew a blank on that. The only thing I could think of was turtle wax. Which no one looks at. Ear wax is also good. Well, I'm sorry.
Paste wax.
What's that?
Johnson's wax.
Hot wax. Johnson. All right. Beeswax. That's what the audience thought. So, Dick, you've got $600. You're going to play another game, meet another challenger. So let's meet Don Hagel. Hi. How are you? Up there, Dick. I guess Don and Dick, you know each other? All right, let's find out a little bit about Don, shall we?
Hi, I'm from Granada Hills, and I have two children, Brett and Paige, and I'm married to a Los Angeles policeman.
No kidding.
Yeah.
Do you two know each other by any chance?
No.
No. Okay.
I've seen her husband. I know her husband.
Oh, you do know her husband.
Fix.
The small world.
Small world, yeah.
Okay, Dawn, we've got to stop and do a little business here. You stand by for a moment or so, and we'll get right back to you. Here's a message for you, friend. All right, we're ready to start a brand new game. We've met our new challenger. Let's push the button and ask her to make a selection.
I think I'll try A.
A, new game, folks. Here we go. Lena.
Horn.
No, just plain old Lena telephoned her husband at the office and said, "You better come right home. That huge St. Bernard of yours just buried our blank." Lena called her husband at the office. Said, "You better come right home. That huge St. Bernard of yours just buried our blank." You're the best.
Well, I haven't even started, and I want another reading on that
question.
That's
right. He has a St. Bernard.
I have a Lhasa Apso.
A Lhasa Apso. I have a Bichon Frise.
Oh, marvelous. Great.
I know how you can clear that up.
All right, Richard Long. Ready. Here we go. Don Hagel.
Yes.
Lena telephoned her husband at the office and said, "You better come right home. That huge St. Bernard of yours just buried our blank."
The only thing I can think of is swimming pool. Bad? Bad?
There we go.
Is that bad?
It really stinks. Bad, Don.
No. Let me put it this
way. That's the answer.
It's bad.
Yes.
That was a great answer.
Really? We'll find out from the dingbats right now.
I like it.
How great it is.
Maybe if Richard, we all tore our cards up in a row, swimming pool would be an excellent answer.
That's right. Richard, what'd you say? You say swimming pool?
Well, maybe it'll be a raid. No, I said child.
Child is the answer.
Oh,
well, it's a good, you know.
Skinny child.
What do you say?
Well, you know, there are those days when I wish I had a St. Bernard. I said kids.
Bury the kids. Okay. That's two for the children.
I said the roast.
Buried the roast.
Roast?
There goes the whole dinner. Okay, what did you say?
Rose.
Yes.
I couldn't decide between if it's a boy or a girl, so I put a car.
Buried the car.
Yes.
Boy car.
Thank you. All right. Boy car. Right.
And your answer, sir.
Quickly. Buried our son.
Buried the swimming pool is what she's looking for. Okay.
I envisioned it.
Last chance for the swimming pool, Kay.
Well, here it is. Child.
There it is.
You would have done
so well with the child.
I know. I know.
Dear Kinder, let's see how you do, Dick Harper, with your first round question, which reads as follows. While cleaning up the operating room at the end of a busy day, the surgeon said, uh-oh. Here's Mrs. Crabtree's blank. Uh-oh. Here it is.
Uh-oh. Here's Mrs. Crabtree's.
You got it?
Well, I don't know.
Really? All right. While cleaning up the operating room at the end of a busy day, the surgeon said, uh-oh, look at this. Holy mackerel, it's Mrs. Crabtree's blank.
I don't know.
You've written 12 answers.
I know, but I don't like any of them.
Well, put one of them in the slop there. And...
can I just put kind of a general thing?
Do anything you want, but do not say anything.
Do not dally is what he's trying to tell you, dear.
Well, that's not what I meant. Well,
see, you all look so bad. Mine.
Okay. All right, everybody's ready now, folks.
I don't even know what I have.
We'll come over here to Dick Harper. While cleaning up the operating room at the end of a busy day, the surgeon says, uh-oh, here is Mrs. Crabtree's
heart.
Heart.
Not bad.
Okay. What did you say, Richard?
Well, her heart was in her eating habits. I said stomach.
Here's her stomach. Heart is the answer. Brett?
Dick, we're back together again.
Oh, what happened?
Heart.
Heart, you've got it. Charles?
Gallbladder.
Gallbladder.
On the operating room table.
Now, what was the thing that you finally came up with?
I do not know. You all shut
up. Well, just got a show and tell.
Oh, well, surprise. A nose.
A nose. We're going to put her together again, aren't we?
What was this lady's name?
Mrs. Crabtree.
I woke up and she said, I assume you think that's funny. I said appendix.
Appendix. And your answer, Kay?
Oh, the ever-popular liver.
Liver. So it's 1-0 at the end of round one. And round two will happen in a little while, but first this has to happen. Now, we've got to stop right here. It's 1-0, and when we... all get together again. We'll pick up right at this point and begin round two. Okay?
Okay.
Will they let you off for to carry on here some more?
For this program, they'll let me off.
Oh, terrific. All right, Dawn, goodbye. And listen,
bye-bye.
You were all just splendid, and I thank you for your kind efforts. Yes, ma'am?
I wanted to say something.
Yes, you may say something.
I wanted to say hello to Richard Long, because the very first television show I ever did out here,
yes,
I did with him, and he was so sweet and kind to me, I'd like to run up and appear again with him.
Okay.
Can I?
You want to do that right now? Okay.
Well, if you did it with me, what are you fooling around with him for?
Now for their farewell appearance. Oh, isn't that sweet?
Thank you, Joanne. That's very sweet.
Now, thank you.
I'd like to apologize for all our friends who have diabetes, too.
I have to get this in. Everybody at the match game loves Punky Chord. Now, you wonder why?
Why?
Because it's performed, scored, and arranged and produced by our beloved makeup man, Vern Langdon. So look for Hunky Chord. Johann Sebastian Bach's It's a wonderful jazzy harpsichord, and you'll do your housework much better if you put it on.
No plugs, please.
No plugs after this.
Now, when we get together next time, we shall present this assorted group of dingbats.
Nipsey Russell, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Anita Gillette, Richard Dawson, and Joanne Worley.
Please join us next time for Match Game 74. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 74, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.